Hey everybody, what's going on? So I'm just back here with another video, just from Pierre Poilievre, and the title of it is called "Unleash Canadian Resources." So there's been a lot of talk about all the natural resources we have, and we're just letting it sit in the ground, and we're not making any money from it. So Pierre Poilievre is going to talk about that a little bit, and then we'll talk about it after, like usual.
In different parts of Canada that were experiencing decline even prior to Trudeau, and had that sped up further under Trudeau, typically rural regions such as this.
No, it's a good question. It's an important question. We have to unleash the power of our resources. Like, what, for example, the Ring of Fire. Imagine what that would do for Northern Ontario. It could be it could potentially be on the magnitude of the oil sands. What the oil sands did for Northern Alberta, that's what the Ring of Fire could do for Northern Ontario. And there'll be massive spin-offs that will ripple out all the way hundreds and hundreds of miles away from the mines themselves. There are going to be roads that need to be built. There'll be machinery that needs to be supplied. There will be daily supplies that need to be delivered. There'll be housing that need to be built for the surrounding workers. And all of that could revitalize these regions. I also think we need a tax reform that rewards investment again, so that when businesses generate a profit, it's advantageous for them to reinvest it rather than just pay it out. And that's what my tax reform is going to do. And I want to get Steve and others, Mike, to advise me on how we could best structure that so that you could reinvest more working capital in your business here and beat your American competitors.
Yeah, so I mean, that's very interesting, right? And like I said before we played the video, it's very important that we get the resources that we have out of the ground and we can sell them. Not to mention we can also use them ourselves, like oil, right? Like we need gas still, right? But we're, instead of getting it from our own country, we're shipping it to us overseas, which now makes it way more expensive, and now we have to use carbon or burn or emit carbon emissions into the sky, and we have to do this just to get our fuel, which then is going to lead to more carbon emissions. So it's actually even worse for the environment to do it this way, right? Like all these boats going overseas and then coming back with our oil and our gas, and it's like, well, why didn't we just get it here? It would have been way cheaper, and we wouldn't have to emit carbon to get our oil, right? Like it doesn't make any sense the way we're doing it. Not to mention there's all kind of wars going over there, like where we're getting, I think we're getting some of our oil from the Middle East. There's always wars going on there. That's obviously not a great situation. And then not to mention, Pierre Poilievre also said he wants to, reform our taxes, making the taxes lower. That's also good news. That makes things cheaper. Right. So I mean, what Trudeau is doing right now clearly isn't working. Everything's too expensive. And it's just like the math doesn't add up. I mean, again, liberals just don't seem to be able to do math. They're just so bad at managing finances. And that's why that's the one good thing about conservatives. Even if you hate them, they're way better at math. They're way better fiscally than liberals are. And it's not even close. Right. So like Pierre Poilievre said, we should be unleashing our own natural resources, because it doesn't really make sense to get it from somewhere else. We have so much of it here. Well, we have all kind of minerals we could be mining and using into selling to other countries and make good money and use it to pay off the national debt. I know Pierre Poilievre hasn't really said much about paying off the national debt, but that being said, it would be an option if we started making more money. Not to mention you'd have better jobs, good paying jobs with unions and benefits and the whole nine yards, right? So it makes a lot of sense to do what he's doing. Right. And that's one of those things that he could probably start to do really quickly. That's not going to take 2 years for him to drop the taxes and to, start to push jobs out there and start to drill, get our resources out of the ground and sell them to other countries who need them too. I think they said in Alberta, we have an oil reserve that's the size of Switzerland or something like that. Like we have so much of it. And while we work on finding new ways for, getting in green energy and being productive that way, we need gas right now. So let's get it as cheap as possible. And let's get it from our own country where we can also create more jobs for people. Everyone wins. Right? And I know, like, environmentalists, they don't really like it. Well, we don't want to drill into the ground. And well, right now, we need to. And if it's not being drilled here, it's being drilled somewhere over in the Middle East or wherever else we're getting our oil. And that's not good. It's still bad for the environment, no matter where it is. It's just costing more now. And you're emitting double the amount of carbon. Right? Like, it just doesn't add up. I know people think that, we have other options. Well, electric cars aren't really a good option right now, especially here in Canada. We need gas. These electric cars are, they're stalling up in the and freezing up a lot of the times in the winter. So that's not going to work either. Right? So this is the only option right now while we work on other ways to produce cleaner energy, whether that be nuclear or whatever it is. I know a lot of people are worried about nuclear power plants because they're Chernobyl, but that being said, generally speaking, apparently it's some of the cleanest and safest ways to produce energy. So I don't know if that's what they're going to be looking into. I do believe Pierre Poilievre will be coming out with his plans once we get close to the election time. Not right now, though, as Trudeau and all these liberals want him to, because he's not going to give Trudeau a good idea, right? Like, he's going to wait until it's just before the election, then he's going to say his whatever his climate change ideas are. And Trudeau won't have enough time to steal and enact those policies to make a change to help him in the polls before the election. So Pierre Poilievre, in it, which is very intelligent of him, is going to wait. Then he's going to reveal his plan, and then we can see if it's a good one or not. And I mean, whether we think it is or not, he's probably going to be the next prime minister anyway. So give him some time, let him do his thing, and we'll see what happens. I mean, that's really the only other option we have. Trudeau and the liberals can say all they want that he has no plan. Just because he's not telling you, that doesn't mean he doesn't have one. Of course, Trudeau wants to hear it because if it's a good idea, he wants to steal it. But either way, nice try, buddy, but it ain't going to work. Let me know what you guys think about, using our own resources. Should we be doing that, or should do you think it's better that we go and get them from other countries? I personally think that's a pretty bad idea, but if you disagree with me, I'd love to hear that, and I'd love to hear why as well. Also, please don't forget to like and subscribe. It really helps grow this channel. I also really, really appreciate all of you who have subscribed so far. We're getting up to close to 2,000 subscribers, which, it's not too bad. I know it's some people comment with a little bit of frustration, like, how come you don't get more views? Well, sometimes the videos just don't get pushed out if the algorithm doesn't like it and you don't hit certain stats. But either way, I do appreciate all of you guys who like and subscribe. And if you're not liking the videos and subscribed, please like and subscribe. Hit that smash, sorry, smash that like button and the subscribe button. Thanks so much again for watching, guys, and I'll be back shortly with another video. Thanks so much for watching this video, guys. I really, really appreciate it. Also, just wanted to let you know and remind you that if you don't mind, I really would appreciate you smashing that like button and subscribing to the channel. It really, really helps the channel grow and further monetization. I really, really appreciate every single one of you who watch, like, subscribe, and comment, whether it's a positive or a negative comment. I always enjoy reading them. I enjoy hearing different people's perspectives. So thanks again so much, guys, for watching. I'll be back shortly with another video. Take care.